The night before this unusual press conference.
What I've read bothers me, and I think it should bother the president.
It turns out House Intelligence Chair Devin Nunes was actually on White House grounds. His spokesman confirming Chairman Nunes met with his source at the White House grounds in order to have proximity to a secure location where he could view the information provided by the source. That's where Nunes tells CNN he viewed information indicating incidental collection of the president's communications. A government official told CNN Nunes was seen at the National Security Council offices of the Eisenhower Executive Office Building. Despite Nunes's assertion that no one from the White House knew he was there, it raises several questions. Who granted Nunes access onto the White House grounds? Who let him into the secure room at the EEOB? And who accessed the computer system to view the files? White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer not providing answers.
I'll be glad to check on that. I'm not sure that's how that works, but I will follow up on that point.
Nunes still hasn't shared the details with intelligence committee members, and Democrats are questioning Nunes's ability to be impartial.
Without further ado, Speaker Ryan should replace Chairman Nunes.
House Speaker Paul Ryan standing by the chair. Speaker Ryan has full confidence that Chairman Nunes is conducting a thorough, fair, and credible investigation. Meanwhile, President Trump's son-in-law and top advisor Jared Kushner has agreed to face members of the Senate Intelligence Committee as new information emerges about his meeting with prominent Russians. The White House previously disclosed Kushner's December meeting at Trump Tower with Russian Ambassador Sergei Kislyak. Now the White House admits Ambassador Kislyak requested a second meeting, to which Kushner sent his deputy, Avram Berkowitz. Kushner then had another meeting at the request of Ambassador Kislyak with Sergei Gorkov, the head of Russia's Economic Development Bank. Through the campaign and transition, Jared Kushner served as the official primary point of contact with foreign governments and officials. Given this role, he has volunteered to speak with Chairman Burr's committee, according to a White House spokesman. Democratic lawmakers continue to express concerns about the Trump team's ties to Russia. Congressman Jim Himes telling CNN's Kate Baldwin this.
This is hardly an isolated case. Michael Flynn, Roger Stone, Paul Manafort, now Jared Kushner, all people who have been a little bit less than forthcoming about what the nature of those meetings were or whether they even occurred. Look, that in and of itself is enough for an investigative committee to want to talk to everybody.